Welcome back, my friends. It is time once again for the Morning Mindset. We're in our Advent celebration. We're in day 26, and today we'll be talking about deliverance. Deliverance that Jesus brought as Messiah and the promises of deliverance that are yet to come. We'll be looking at Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 14 through 17. That's an Old Testament book that I venture to say most of us have not read very much of. And today we're going to dig into it a little bit. Before we do, I want to invite you to reach out to me. Tell me a little bit about yourself, about your life, about how I can be praying for you. I read every email and I try to respond to everyone. You can reach me at Carrie, C-A-R-E-Y, at CarrieGreen, just like the color, .com. All right, let's dive into Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 14 through 17. Here is what it says in a prophecy about the Messiah who was coming to Israel. It says, "Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O Israel." So let yourself be grabbed by the emotion of that. Sing aloud and shout. It's like a shout of excitement. "Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem." So this is an exciting moment. This is an admonition to be excited about what is happening. And here's what it is he's about to describe that is going to happen. "The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has cleared away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall never again fear evil." Now, friends, I want to stop right there. I just want to highlight that these things are true for us right now. As believers in Jesus Christ, we are the Lord's. He has made us his own. He shelters us with his love and with his divine providence. And even though we may have physical enemies, in the long term, in the view of eternity, we really have no enemies. Because if the Lord is for us, who can be against us? Amen? And he says, "The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst, and we have no reason to ever fear again." Friends, our God dwells within us through Jesus Christ. Can you comprehend that? Can you get your heart and your mind around that? This is reason for rejoicing, like Zephaniah is telling us. Now, verse 16, he's going to look a little bit toward the future and a little bit toward our present, which was his future. He says, "On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear not, O Zion. Let not your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a mighty one who will save. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will quiet you by his love. He will exult over you with loud singing." Now, friends, you may have a difficult time imagining those last few phrases to be true. That God himself rejoices over you with gladness. That he's present in your life to quiet you by his love. So that means to calm your anxiety, to still your heart, to give you a sense of peace and tranquility in your life because of his presence. And it may be difficult for you to imagine that he exults over you with loud singing. So this passage began with Zephaniah encouraging us to sing loudly because of what God has done for us. But it ends with a reminder and a reassurance that God actually is singing over us. He does so in delight, and he does so as a treasure that he is holding close to his heart. Friends, do you see God in this way? And if not, do you see that he sent Jesus to come and draw you close to himself in this way? Jesus is the way to the Father. It's through our faith in him and our reliance upon him that we come into the presence of the Father. And that is where the Father then rejoices over us. He quiets us by his love. He exults over us with loud singing because we are coming to him humbly in faith that Jesus has made the way for us to come to him. Friends, this Christmas, let's avail ourselves of the deliverance that God has provided through Jesus. Let's not let his coming, so to speak, be in vain in our lives because we don't acknowledge it and we don't appropriate the realities and the practical changes that can happen in our lives. because we are knowing and focusing on the truths of what it means for us that Jesus is our deliverer. Oh, Jesus, teach us this Christmas how to see you as the one who has cleared away our enemies, the one who has taken away the judgments against us, how to see that you rejoice over us with gladness and you quiet us with your love and that you exult over us with loud singing. Jesus, give us eyes to see and hearts to receive the truth of what you've done for us this Christmas season. In your name we pray.